I would say beginning of 1940, I don't remember the exact date, and we were still living in Oświęcim, and the street where we lived was leading right into the camp. And one day they told us nobody could walk out into the street, nobody. And we saw military cars passing by, and in one of the cars was Himmler.
How did you know it was Himmler?
People that knew him from pictures or whatever, they told us that this was him.
Where was he going?
I presume he was going to the camp, to the future camp.
The camp is Auschwitz.
Auschwitz.
When the camp was being built, did your hometown watch it being built?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I worked in the camp, and I was going home every day. But we didn't know what we were building. So there were barracks there already, because before the war there was the military barracks there, military personnel. And so I guess they wanted to enhance it or build more barracks, so that's what we were doing.
What were you told was being built there?
We weren't told anything. But one day on our street, we saw prisoners in the uniform, in the striped uniforms, and they were like measuring the street, and they were speaking Polish. They were from the Polish intelligentsia, like engineers and professionals. And my mother gave me a sandwich, and I went out and I threw it, you know, so nobody, when the SS didn't see, I threw it over them. They picked it up, because we knew that they must have been hungry. These were Polish prisoners.
What kind of work did you do there?
In Auschwitz, in that, we were doing like carpeting work, you know, carrying the lumber and things like that for the carpenters.
Did you have to work there?
Yes.
According to who?
According to the Germans.
Every
morning we had to assemble at the certain place, and then we were escorted towards the camp, and then in the evening we went home.
How did that come about? How did the Germans come into your town?
They came to the town right, I think, either the first or second day after the war started, because we were just a few kilometers away. So they came just like to any other town, not particularly because it was Oświęcim. I doubt they knew already at that time there's going to be a camp over there. But eventually they picked this town. It was a town where the trains came from all different directions there. So I guess this was suitable for them.